Innovation on the rotary axis. Now I can do things I never thought I could do before. If I succeed with such a cool design, it will definitely awaken people to build their own machines. Hi guys. Is your crafting going well? Creating something is a lot of fun. If you can make your ideal machine that does not exist in the world, your desire will be satiated. I can enjoy drinking while looking at it. I think people who watch this channel have more or less the same feeling as I do. I am trying to build a desktop 5-axis CNC machine with overwhelming performance that I will fall in love with, purely because I want to enjoy crafting. So, what kind of machine is that one-of-a-kind machine that you fall in love with? Is it a machine you can buy online? Is it a machine with a common design? I was not satisfied with such a machine. It would be a very insane machine. And I want something more innovative. That's why I am creating this crazy DIY machine tool. If the machine I designed was a commonplace one, you would not be interested in this project. Don't you agree? The carbon fiber epoxy granite test I posted last time was also an insane idea that turned out to be a success. And I was more inspired by the experience of testing it than I ever thought I would be. Whether I was eating, drinking, or in the bathroom, I was thinking hard about the possibilities. And I kept thinking about how I could make a cool machine that would satisfy me more. I thought too much about it, and I thought I had lost about 5 kilograms of weight. But, in fact, I didn't lose any weight. At that time, I was thinking seriously, and I looked just like Keanu Reeves when he was younger. I think some people even said I looked like Tom Cruise. Even if I had been too cool in my seriousness, and beautiful women had invited me to enjoy a drink with them at a bar, I would not have been in the mood to do so. However, if such an invitation actually came my way, I would not refuse it. Because if I refused their invitation, it would be rude to them. I would feel sorry for them if their hearts were deeply broken and they became sick because of my refusal. However, I would not have been able to truly enjoy drinking with these women. But in fact, none of the beautiful women invited me to join them. Maybe I was too dazzling to approach them. Oops, I'm getting off topic. Back to the story. In short, after thinking about the possibilities of carbon fiber epoxy granite, I began to think that I could do something that I had previously thought was impossible. We decided to make a new carbon fiber epoxy granite C-axis. Then I decided to redesign the A-axis and C-axis. It turned out to be very original and cool. First, let's talk about the previous design. This design is based on machining aluminum plates, making parts, and assembling them. I really wanted to make a frame by machining castings like the A and C axes of industrial machine tools, but such a large material is not available and I do not have the machining facilities. So I gave up. My next thought was to make the frame out of epoxy granite, but the C axis would be very small and complex in shape, with several thin sections. Epoxy granite is an excellent material, but when it is thin, it can crack. It is common to embed materials such as aluminum or other metals to prevent cracking, but there is no space to embed metals in thin areas. Even if these problems could be solved, it is very likely that something would have to be additionally machined if problems arise during the assembly process. However, epoxy granite is mostly stone because it is made of sand and gravel. It would be very difficult to modify it later. That is why I gave up on making C-axis with epoxy granite. However, after experimenting with carbon fiber epoxy granite, I changed my mind. I now understand the characteristics of carbon fiber and epoxy granite. I can overcome what I used to think as the reason why I could not do it. Issues that can be overcome. 1. Measures to be taken for thinner areas. The areas that will be thin should be partially made of 100% carbon fiber with carbon chips. Even though carbon fiber is thin, it will not crack as easily as epoxy granite. 2. Reinforcing epoxy granite. Epoxy granite is usually reinforced with metals such as aluminum, but carbon plates are used instead. The formwork into which the epoxy granite is poured is fabricated with carbon plates, and the joints are filled with carbon chips and epoxy to integrate them. The carbon fiber formwork reinforces the tensile strength of the epoxy granite without being removed. 3. Beautiful appearance. If the frame is made of epoxy granite only, the surface will be full of air bubbles if the air is not released properly. It is difficult to repair, and at worst, it may have to be rebuilt. However, by making the formwork with carbon plates first, a beautiful factory-produced surface is guaranteed. 4. Modification. Epoxy granite is very difficult to cut and file. In comparison, carbon fiber is easy to cut with specialized tools. Fine modification is very easy with a diamond file. Even if a mistake is made, it can be easily repaired with epoxy and carbon chips. 5. Seamless materials. Both epoxy granite and carbon fiber are fabricated with the same epoxy. Materials used are carbon plate, carbon chips, carbon mesh, gravel and sand. All materials except the carbon plate are hardened with the same epoxy. If all the work is completed before the epoxy has completely cured, a fully integrated material can be produced. This is a great advantage in strength. All of this convinced me that the C-axis could be fabricated from carbon fiber epoxy granite. This means that if I can make a good formwork, it will be possible to create a very complex shape. The design will be more difficult, but the completed product will be very sophisticated. If you take the time to think and try to make something excellent, it will naturally be cool. Let me now introduce you to my newly designed A and C axes. This design took several weeks. I designed this machine to fit in this soundproof box within 400 mm square. Deciding on the placement of each part was very difficult. I will explain the differences from the previous design. 1. The base of the C-axis was changed from aluminum to carbon fiber epoxy granite. I expect it to be stronger. The thinner part of the base of the C-axis will be made of carbon plates, carbon chips, and carbon cloth to prevent cracking. Epoxy granite will be used for the thicker part. 2. Fix the A-axis motor to the column. This change was made because it became difficult to mount the A-axis motor on the C-axis due to its structure. 3. Cross bearing is used for C-axis. The previous design used a tapered bearing, but this was changed to use a large diameter bearing to increase strength, reduce size, and make a large through hole in the center. 4. Improved backlash. This is very important change in the design. It is the backlash countermeasure. Worm gears are used for the rotating axis. Normally, worm gears have backlash. This is because there is a gap between the worm wheel and worm shaft. The 5-axis CNC machine I built last time has a structure that presses the worm shaft against the worm gear as an anti-backlash measure. This structure eliminated the backlash. However, this structure could not maintain the correct distance between the worm wheel and worm shaft recommended by the manufacturer. In order to apply the preload, the worm shaft had to be flexible, so there was a concern about its strength. In fact, the rotary axis of the previous 5-axis machine was not as strong as it should have been. To prevent backlash, I decided to use 2 worm shafts. The 2 worm shafts are synchronized by a timing belt. The backlash is reduced to 0 by setting the worm shafts so that they are offset by the amount of backlash. This is my first time trying this method. Theoretically, it should be possible, but I am not sure if the results will be as I imagine. Some may be dismissive of this structure, but doesn't it sound interesting? Even if it fails completely, I think there is a lot to learn from it. But I believe that with the help of alcohol I can solve all the problems. I believe my crazy alcohol-soaked brain will solve the problem. Yes. We can. Drink. In addition, the C-axis is designed to mount an ER40 collet chuck. This collet chuck can chuck materials up to Fi26M. Bar material can be used easily. The ER40 is also used in pocket NC, and the same concept is used in pocket NC. The chuck head is smaller than the table, so the spindle does not interfere with the chuck. Anyway, I was able to design the A and C axes to my satisfaction. Some people who have been watching the project from the beginning may be frustrated because it is not easy to get the work done. However, taking time to design is important to make something good. When individuals build something, they often design while building. In such cases, the work is created by adding on to the first part created. This is fine, but the final product is inefficient, large, and looks bad. The 5-axis CNC machine I built last time was started before the design was completed. If I wanted to change the design of a part once it was built, it would all be for nothing. As a result, I had to add parts that were not needed without rebuilding. As a result, I could not create something that satisfied me completely. Based on this experience, I believe that taking enough time to think about the design is the best way to make a good product quickly. I am sure that there will be minor changes in the future, but nothing as major as this one. Perhaps, from now on, I will be able to concentrate on building the machine. I need various innovations in the production process. Of course, this design is also thoughtful about how it will be built. I don't think you can know what I have in mind just by looking at this design. If you are interested in seeing how I accomplish this with only my limited equipment, I recommend you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss the next video. If you empathize with my project, why don't you become a member and support this channel? There are few benefits, but as long as you are a member, your name will appear at the end of the videos as a patron. In other words, you can be a part of this project. So, please look forward to the next video.